We've been watching Tropical Storm Cristobal all day, and it still has not yet made landfall. The center of it is about 60 miles south of New Orleans. Right now, as of the 4 p.m. advisory, it still has 50-mile-an-hour winds, and we've been getting some winds that have been gusting up to 30 miles an hour in our area, and we'll continue to see gusty winds with this even as it makes landfall and then gets a little bit closer to us. Current path takes this right through the southwestern part of Mississippi over the course of the next 12 hours, and that is going to bring us a lot of very heavy rain. Thankfully, this thing gets lifted out of here pretty quickly. It's going to get caught up in the jet stream and taken out of our way, but through the rest of today, tonight and tomorrow, we're going to be dealing with bouts of very heavy rain with those rain bands coming in. The potential for flash flooding is there and, of course, gusty winds. But we are expecting Cristobal to make landfall this evening with heavy rain and gusty winds, especially starting to pick up this evening and through early tomorrow morning. It's going to be the worst. But we will see throughout the course of the day into tomorrow the potential for 2 to 4 inches of rain area wide, with 5 inches of rain possible or even more in some spots in our southern counties and down towards the coast, where they're also dealing with incredible storm surge right now. 15 to 30 mile an hour winds will be consistent throughout our area, with gusts as high as 40 miles an hour through the rest of today, tonight, and even tomorrow as well. And even into Tuesday, there will be some breezy winds, but it won't be quite as bad. Map representation showing all of the very heavy rain potential for areas in our southern counties and then into southeast Mississippi. 5 inches of rain or more is possible there, while the rest of us are going to end up with 2 to 4 inches of rain. It really depends on where those heavy rain bands set up for the exact location of some of those heavier rains. We are expecting at least a few showers to come rotating in here from the east through the evening, but it's really not going to be until the late evening that we'll see the core of the heavy rain move in. That's going to be a lot closer to the center of the storm, and we'll start to see that creep up from the south right around 9 or 10 p.m. with incredibly heavy rain continuing to move in as this thing lifts to the north. By midnight, we should be seeing the start of this heaviest rain band approaching I-20, and then it will continue to lift north through the course of the morning. By the time we get to 7 o'clock or so, we may actually get a little bit of a break from all of the widespread heavy rain before a second rain band starts to move in. This is going to be more of an outer rain band into the afternoon as Cristobal moves away. The problem with what's going to happen tomorrow afternoon, the rain will be more focused into heavier bands, but they're going to be very narrow. We also have a few breaks in the clouds here forecast, which could mean that there's the potential for a brief weak spin up for tomorrow afternoon too in some of these rain bands. That is very typical with these landfalling tropical systems, and that is a very far third kind of threat. The first threat is going to be the very heavy rain. The second is going to be the flash flooding, and then this would be a third kind of threat. So not really going to be too worried about that in general. It's going to be more about the heavy rain that's going to affect more people through tomorrow. As we go into Tuesday morning, all of the moisture out of our way, and we will no longer be dealing with anything related to Cristobal. There will be a couple of lingering showers or thunderstorms possible just because it's hot and humid, but there's not going to be anything organized like what we're expecting through tonight and tomorrow. Wednesday, a cold front will be moving through, again bringing the chance for a few showers and thunderstorms, but after that passes through, the rest of the week looks fantastic. Lots of sunshine, low humidity, mornings in the middle 60s, and afternoons in the upper 80s.